Dear students, today here we will be studying various valves and fittings. These are some of the fittings and those are the valves. So starting with the valves, this is a two-way valve. So in this two-way valve, we can see that in this construction, we are having a valve which is this and this is the valve seat. So this portion here we can see this is just like a conical frustum, means a truncated cone in which the shape is having a larger diameter on one side and a smaller diameter on other side. Similar type of construction is for this valve seat as well. So that when this valve will be fitting into valve seat, it can cause a very close contact and it can prevent any leakage. So here in this valve, we can see that it has two of the ends. So one of any of the end can be used as an inlet and other end will be used as out. So for providing passage of fluid flow, similar kind of construction is also there for this valve. So this valve has a through hole from the center of it, so that when this valve will be inserted into valve seat, then this hole can be aligned directly through this opening so that it can let the flow occur. So here we can see when this handle of valve is in direction of any of this inlet or outlet pipeline, then this valve is open. If this valve is turned at 90 degrees, then here we can see it has completely blocked the flow from both ends and it will be then closed. So here we can see that if we are seeing it in this particular way, so hole is at 90 degrees, so the hole of valve and hole of this valve body are not in alignment with each other, so it will be blocking the flow completely, so that is valve is turned off. And when this valve is rotated in the direction of either inlet or outlet, so here we can see this hole will be aligned with this valve body, so valve will be open. Now to prevent any leakage from this valve, we have an arrangement of here a screw and a bolt. So here we can tighten a bolt from this particular end so that this valve can tightly fit into this valve body, and there are two gaskets. So here we can see there is one provision of a O-ring or a gasket to be installed at this side, and this side we can see that a gasket has already been installed. So similar kind of gasket can be installed here. When this valve will be closed and then tightened, then it will be forming a leakage proof seal. Similarly, we can see other kind of valves, two-way valves. Here at the bottom we are not having any nut and bolt, but on the contrary at the top side we are having this closure. So here we can see that it is having this threading onto this closure as well as this body. In this case it was not there, but in this case we are having a threading on this valve body as well as this closure, and rest of the working of this valve will be similar. So here we can see this is frustum or conical shape for this valve as well as valve body, and this can tightly fit together. And to stop this valve from leakage, we are providing this additional packing ring which is also made of stainless steel, and then we can install this closure and tighten it to prevent leakage. So in order to operate this valve, whenever we are required to open or close this valve, this closure has to be first loosened, not removed, and then we can turn this valve in the required direction depending on whether we are required to open or close it, and then again tighten this valve closure so that we can have a correct operation of this valve. So here we can see there are several sizes of these kind of valves. So depending on the pipeline size, a suitable size of the valve can be used. So here we are having on this valve body, on both sides we are having this kind of connection, so which is required to be flush with the pipeline. So to have this kind of connection, we are having this union joints. So union joint will be like this. So on one side we are having one of the pipeline or valve, on another side we will be having another pipeline, and in between we will be having this kind of central nut. So here we can see there are four parts of union. This part will be connected to one of the pipeline, this part will be connected to another pipeline, and in between, to make it leakage proof, we are having this gasket or seal so that it can fit onto this groove here, and then it can fit onto another facing groove at this side, and then it can be inserted into this housing like this. So to have this properly tightened or properly connected,
This union nut can be tightened by using a C clamp. So C clamp will be used to tighten this union like this. So here we can see. So this is a union joint in between. So this can be opened or closed and tightened. So here we are seeing a smaller version of this union with one piece at this particular end, another piece at this particular end, a sealing gasket in between, and this nut which is mounted on this side of the piece which is unthreaded. So at this nut we are having internal threading, on this pipeline piece we are having external threading, and on another side of this pipeline we are not having any threads, but a lip is there so that it is preventing coming out of this pipeline at this end. So this can be just fitted by tightening of this nut at this end. So depending on in which direction this fitting is required to be connected, we can loosen or tighten and then adjust this tightening force onto this central nut. Now coming on to other kind of valves. So here we can see one more two-way valve, but its construction is a bit different from other two-way valves. So in this construction we can see that it is a very smaller version with this nut and bolt. So here this is the valve and this is the valve seat. Both are having this conical shape and it can fit together, but from the external point of view we can see this is a kind of cubical valve. This is one more kind of valve which is a two-way valve again, but this is ball valve. So here we can see that it is connected with this handle and this handle can be rotated in this direction, but in another direction it cannot. So here we can see that this handle has been bent at this side and this bent will be preventing any further motion by this, and similarly there is a provision to stop its motion at this end. So we will be having only this direction of movement. So at the center we can see that we are having a ball. So this is a stainless steel ball which will be rotated by operating this handle. So while this handle is in perpendicular direction to this pipeline it is closed, and when it is in parallel direction we can see the holes are aligning and this will be in open condition. Here we can see this is a three-way valve. The difference between two-way and three-way valve is that in addition to these two connections which are at 180 degree to each other, we are having one more pipeline connection which is at 90 degree to this main pipe. A similar kind of provision is there at this valve also. So here we can see in this valve we are having this hole which is having connection at this junction in the form of T. So whatever fluid is going in this direction can come out in from this hole as well as this hole, and similarly any of the hole is connected to other two holes. Same is the construction for this valve body. So we are having this side which is connected to this valve body, this side also connected, and this side is also connected. So same as per this whole direction, this has the similar geometry onto this portion also. Now regarding how to operate this valve, how it works, that if we are placing these holes which are aligning to each other, then this is open in all directions. It means whatever fluid is passing through any of these pipeline will be also coming out from other two pipelines. If any is coming from this direction, it will be going in this as well as this direction. Similarly, if any fluid is going in this direction, so it will come out from these two directions and vice versa. Now to control this valve, we can have several positions. So this valve will be having four positions, unlike the valve which was having two positions, which was on and off only. In this case, if this handle is in this 90 degree direction or this branch pipeline, then this valve is fully open. All three waves are open to each other. If this branch is in one of these five directions, then opposite to this handle direction is closed and these two pipelines are connected. If this is in this direction, then opposite to this handle side is closed, these two directions are connected to each other. If it is in this direction, then opposite to this handle means this side will be closed and these two sides will be connected. Now how it will occur is, we can see this geometry of these holes which are getting aligned. So if it is in this direction, all three holes are aligned to each other, so it will be open for all sides. If it is in this direction, then here we can see that we are having here no hole, but here there is a hole will be blocked by this wall here, and this side it will be connected to this hole, and this side it will be connected to this hole, and this hole will be blocked by this wall. So only these two directions will be connected. Similarly, if we rotate it in this direction, then this side will be closed by this wall and this side will be closed by this wall, and these two directions will be connected to each other. If it is in this direction, then this through hole will be connected, but this hole will be blocked by this wall and this hole will be blocked by this wall. So only 180 degree transmission will be possible. So these valves, either two-way valve or three-way valve, will be used to control only fluid in both direction. Means it will be allowing fluid whatever is going from this direction, same direction reversal is possible. Means if this is allowing fluid to go in this direction, coming out in this direction, then if fluid is coming in this direction, then it can also come out in this direction, and no direction preference is there. And this is the valve cover which will be required to open and close by tightening and loosening of the connection. So here we can see that the two different sizes, a smaller valve and a larger valve. Now coming on to the direction selection valve. So this is a one-way valve or unidirectional valve. This is automatic and this does not have any operating parts to be operated manually. Now how this valve will be work and how the direction selection, here we that this kind of one-way valve is only having two. So what are the two parts here? Here we can see that in this valve we are having this valve body and this valve seat, and this is the valve itself. So this valve, when it will be inserted and fitting in this direction, so whatever fluid is coming in this direction, here we can see that it has completely blocked this through hole from this body, so no fluid can pass when it is coming in this direction. But in the reverse case, if fluid is coming in this direction, it will push this valve away, and while pushing this valve away, it will be creating these slots or holes here. So here we can see there are some gaps which are created due to these holes, and here inside there is a curved surface in this body. So this curved surface in this body connected to these holes, so that whatever fluid is coming in this direction can make a curve and flow through these holes and emerge out in this direction. So to prevent this valve to moving further, piece of union which will be connected in this upstream will be in such a direction that it will not let this piece to travel further, and it will be stopping this flow here only. So this is how this unidirectional or one way valve works. So this valve will have several names by which we can know it. It is called as one way valve, it is also called as unidirectional valve, it is called as check valve, and depending on the application, if it is used at the lowermost, be also called as foot valve. So it will be allowing fluid to flow from this direction towards this direction and not reverse. So it will be only having fluid flow in one direction. Now coming on to other cases. So these are some of the fittings which we can use. So this kind of fitting is known as an elbow. The use of elbow is to connect two pipelines at 90 degrees. So here we can see different sizes of elbows are there. So depending on what size of pipeline is required to be connected, we can have these kinds of elbow. So these elbows, here we can see that they are already provided with this union already welded to these ends. So this is the kind of elbow wherein this union can be welded to have a close contact and joined together. So this piece of pipe will be inserted at this side, and this piece of pipe can be inserted at this side so that it gets connected to the union. So it will be then expanded from inside, and here we can do some welding. Similarly, in this piece, it will be expanded from this side, and here welding can be done to produce this kind of piece. So here we can see this elbow, it can be either connected to union or it can be directly welded to the pipeline. So here we can see other piece of pipeline. This is called as T junction. So in this T junction, we can see that a main pipeline has a branch in between. So at 90 degrees, it is branching off. So if there is an application in which a main pipeline is required to have a branch, then this kind of pipe, this piece can be installed either by using these unions or by directly welding it to the pipeline. So any combination can be used like this also. So we can have this kind of branch connection, we can also have this kind of branch connection, this kind of branch connection, and many other things. So this straight pipeline can be also connected to some valves or other fittings by a suitable size of union or welding. So these are some kinds of pipe fittings and valves. Here we can see this is another elbow, but in this case this is of non-sanitary type. Here we can see a sharp 90 degree turn is there, but this sharp 90 degree turn is not there in this kind of elbow. So here there is a smooth curve, here there is a sharp turn. So this kind of elbow is having this threading and this is not having threading. So it can be welded to the other fittings, either it can be union or other piece of pipeline.